And I'm Allie Tuohy, tracking the latest in the race for the 27th Congressional District. Another Republican entering an increasingly crowded field. Erie County Comptroller Stefan Mihailu is now the fourth vying for the job. State Senator Robert Ort, Attorney Beth Parlato, and State Senator Chris Jacobs announced their candidacies last year.
Website official, Erie County Comptroller Stefan Mihailu finally sharing what many speculated for a while. He's running for New York 27.
I think President Trump needs a cheerleader in Congress. I'm a true conservative.
We're going to go to the end of the book.
The conservative Republican discussing his campaign platform of tax cuts and job growth at his Hamburg home Wednesday. 7 months behind State Senator Chris Jacobs, 5 months after State Senator Robert Ort.
$400,000 that I've raised.
And 6 months behind Attorney Beth Parlato.
I'm running this race very organically. And, you know, what you see and who you see and how I talk is just what you get, because I really just want to always be authentic and be true to myself.
The one Republican named on the ballot may well be decided by just 8 people. Here's why. Should Governor Cuomo officially call for a special election on April 28th, then the 8 county Republican chairman would choose one candidate to run against Democratic opponent Nate McMurray. Parlato respects but disagrees with the process.
I don't think that a congressional race should be decided by 8 people. I think the people want to vote.
She knows she's an underdog and says she plans to run in the June primary regardless of a special election outcome. As for Mihailu, he says it's too soon to say whether he'd run in June, but knows what it takes to win, noting 3 victories for his current countywide post.
If they pick someone who's never won in a dark blue county, they might as well hand the seat right to Nancy Pelosi.
On another note, Mihailu's term as comptroller isn't up until 2021, so he isn't losing his job by taking this leap. If there is a special election in April, the winner would only serve the remainder of Chris Collins' term. A candidate would still need to win the general election next November to serve the full 2-year term. Allie Tuohy, 7 Eyewitness News.